Hey, hey, pilots, thanks for checking out another Keys to Winning video. I'm your host, Gotcha Beacons, been playing this game for about 6 years now. This is my baby account. I'm going to call this battle My Guilty Pleasure, and I'll explain why as we go along here. All right, guys, this is my closed map deck for maps that have less long-range and mid-range opportunities. We got Whizbang, my Mag Blitz, with a pretty decent module, and lots of skills with Clive there, pretty good there. Then we've got Sucker Punch. He's my Flamethrower Scorpion. There's his module, and still working on getting the skills built up there. And we got Diehard, my brand-new Ravana. He's Ice Chucker Ravana. It's really basic on the skills and on the modules. Then we got Sir Nightmare. That's my Nightingale, and he's got a really fairly good set of skills there, a decent module, and that's a nice one. And then we got everyone's favorite Diablo with the very good anti-control and lots of skills. And then we got my Titanits and Notons. I call it Hail Mary. She's got stock weapons, stock modules, and there are the levels. There you go, guys. Hey, if you're new to my channel, please do me a favor and subscribe. Please like the episode, make a comment, and share it with a friend. We're gonna start this battle with Sucker Punch. This is my Flamethrower Scorpion here. I'm gonna move him into the belly of the beast here in Dreadnought. This is where I like to go. Still unused, new to him, and he got out-suckered. Yeah, one scorpion to another, that's what happens here. So that was pretty quick work. Now this is Whizbang, he's my Mag Blitz. He's ferocious as all get out. Those mags never run out. And I'm not much of a brawler, guys. I play more of a beaconeer kind of a thing. This is my Keys to Winning, and I teach you how to basically focus on the beacons and not so much on combat. And some of these builds I have, they are about combat. I try to wade into the beginning of a domination battle, and there goes Whizbang already. Now this is Diehard, he's my Ravana. Now he's got the cryo weapon, so he chucks ice cubes at you. And I'm still working on him. He's only got a few piloting skills. He's got the legendary on him, but I'm still working on some things here, guys, but I am trying to keep him blue. This is how I always play my games for domination, for sure. This is methodical and paced out, but I'm not a very good brawler, so even though I'm trying to go after beacons and I'm trying to use some combat to get there, sometimes I just get wasted and I'm not a very good brawler. So sometimes I have to use one of my other guys, and I have a guy, he's my guilty pleasure, and you're gonna see him pretty soon here. See what more we can do here with my Diehard here. He is hard to kill though, by the way. He's still surviving pretty good, but there he goes. So here is Diablo. Diablo is my guilty pleasure. Guys, I am a beaconeer through and through. I am a horrible brawler. I have bad instincts when it comes to knife fighting and brawling and combat and all. But when it comes to beacon capping and beacon running, this is my guilty pleasure. This is what I do well. This is what I am good at. Know your strengths and take advantage of them. And when you're gonna be a capper, if you're gonna be a runner, if you like running for beacons, this guy here, Diablo, is about as good as they come. He is my guilty pleasure. He allows me to do exactly what I like doing, and that is managing the beacons. Yeah, he's got some skills on him. There's a reason he didn't get tagged. And also, you have to understand how he works. If he's higher, then they're gonna get you. You gotta always look for elevation. So if you're gonna be a low-key pilot, make sure that you're working on elevations as you're trying to evade attacks. Higher and lower is what you're trying to do. I'm always going up and down hills for a reason. I want their shots to go over my head or under my head. If they have quantum radar, it's tough, but you always want to make sure you know who's got quantum radar and who can hit you. And then see that Minos coming at me? I hit my phase shift because I thought he might do a little rush in on me, so I made sure I was safe. I don't want Diablo to die. And what I'm doing right now is just going around and keeping them blue while my mates are worrying about the combat. I don't do too good on combat. Someone just chunked me way down. Luckily, I have one of those chips that saved me at the end there, and that worked out pretty good. So now I'm gonna go here and just keep them blue. My the Ao Ming on my team did not stick around, but he saw me coming, and he saw a the Notons on my team coming, so he just went right back up an airborne, and we grabbed that one. Now we got this Typhon that's coming over here to keep me from getting this one blue. I thought I had it, but he ran over here. But he's obviously having to worry about staying covered, so I'm gonna try to time my attacks. That's right, I'm pulling my guns right there on a really nasty Typhon that could really screw with me. But at the same time, look at the panicometer. We are inside the time warp. We have four beacons. We might just win this one as long as I can keep this guy occupied occupied, it looks like the rest of my team is doing a pretty good job of coming back on the beacons. This is my guilty pleasure. This is why I love Diablo so much. He allows me to do so many kind of different things. Imagine any other bot in the battle trying to pull this one off with a Typhon. Couldn't have done it. Dylan, my little signature move there, removed my my name tag so he could see me because I was under stealth, and so he could see who was facing him at the end. Look at that. Hardly any damage, guys. It doesn't matter. We won the game through beacon management and beacon dominance, and that's what I love to do. That's my guilty pleasure, and Diablo, he allows me to take advantage of that. And if you see your name, thanks for the game. Peace out, guys.